Hello everyone. Now we are continue with our topic, that is the pressure ulcer. It is the second part of pressure ulcer. Okay. In this topic, we have to deal with the stages of pressure ulcer. So let's start the topic. So these are the stages, okay, of the pressure ulcer. And the staging system for the pressure ulcer are based on the describing the depth of tissue loss. So the means staging system is based on the depth of tissue lost on that particular area. Okay, so first stage is the non-blanchable redness, second is the partial thickness, third is the full thickness skin loss, fourth stage full thickness tissue loss, fifth is unstageable, means full thickness skin and tissue are lost and depth will be unknown, and suspected depth, that is tissue injury and depth also are not be known in this stage. Okay, these are the stages. Here you see in stage one there is a redness, so means here the redness on the epidermis of the skin. Okay, stage two, the skin is lost up to the dermis, epidermis. Okay, and here in stage 3 there is a loss of tissue up to the subcutaneous, and here stage 4 tissue are lost up to the wall. Stage 1 is non-blanchable redness, means when you are going to apply pressure on the on that area where you see redness, okay, on the bony prominence area where you see redness, there is no change in color. Okay, the color is not be changed when you're going to apply a little pressure on that redness area. So this is the meaning of a non-blanchable redness. In this stage, intact skin present with non-blanchable redness of a localized area, that like a bony prominence area, means intact skin, the skin is having no damage, there is no type of any kind of damage on the skin. So intact skin with non-blanchable redness, okay, you can see there is a no tissue are we lost, and there is a non-blanchable redness. Okay, discoloration of skin, little discoloration may be occur, warmth, edema at that side, hardness and pain may be present on that localized area. Okay, and in case of dark skin pigment person, you are not able to see non-blanchable, means they have visible, not visible blanching. So blanching process is not visible. Okay, you cannot predict in a dark skin patient stage 1. Okay, stage 1 is not predictable in dark skin patients. Stage 1 may be difficult to detect in a dark skin. So that's the reason why they you cannot able to predict the stage 1 in dark patient, dark skin tone person, because here you are not see the non-blanchable redness. Okay, that's the reason. Here the diagram of a tissue that you see at the epidermis, here redness on the epidermis, there is no tissue injured, only the that area injured area is red. Okay, all the skin are intact. Now see the second stage, here partial thickness has been lost. So loss of dermis present a shallow open ulcer with red pink wound bed, the side of the wound is in red pink color. Okay, and with some sludge. So in second stage you can see on the patient that loss of epidermis up to epidermis has been lost, and there is shallow opening of the wound, and the wound side is red and pink and have some sludge. Okay, स्लज इज ए काइंड ऑफ येलो सिक्रेशन. ओके, सॉफ्ट येलो सिक्रेशन. एंड यू कैन ऑल्सो सी देर ऑल्सो प्रेजेंस ए इंटैक्ट ओपन रैप्चर सीरम फील्ड और सेरोसिगेनियस फ्लूइड ब्लिस्टर ऑन द स्किन मे बी इंटैक्ट and maybe open. If it is it if it is opened, then they it have a serous fluid or serum fluid and a serosgenous fluid blisters. Okay, so these are the this is the difference between stage 1 and stage 2. Here you see some blister formation that is filled with serum fluid and maybe serosgenous fluid. This is the stage 2. The epidermis and dermis has been lost. Okay, here you can see this is a dermis layer, epidermis layer, and this is dermis layer. Okay, so up to dermis has been means dermis is not be not be lost in this stage, but dermis can be visible. Only epidermis and small layer of the dermis has been lost. Okay, the third stage is a full thickness skin loss. In this stage, the loss of subcutaneous fats and these fats may be visible, but the bone and tendon and muscles are not be exposed to the outside. Okay, and there is a in the third stage there is a presence of sludge, and but this sludge does not obscured the depth of tissue loss, so it does not hamper the depth of tissue loss. Means we can easily assess that it is a third stage of the pressure ulcer. Okay, like in case bridge nose, ear, occiput, and malleolus, these are the bony prominence area. In this area they do not have subcutaneous fat layer. Okay, so third layer can be shallow, means the third stage not be common on this area. Okay, understand? This is the diagram of tissue lost in third stage. Okay, this is the epidermis, dermis, and there is some amount of subcutaneous fat has been lost. Okay, but the bone and tendon are not be visible. Okay, now we are going to see the stage 4. In this stage there is full tissue loss. Okay, there is a full tissue loss. There is a loss of subcutaneous fat and fats can be visible, may be visible, but in four stages there is fat has been lost. Only the bone and tendon and muscles are exposed in the environment, in the outside of the bone. Okay, but if only the subcutaneous fat is visible, the bone tendon not be exposed. There is a presence of sludge or ester may be present. Okay, this is diagram of stage 4. It show the full tissue loss. Okay, so here up to the muscles has been lost and bone is exposed to the environment. Next is the unstageable and full thickness tissue or skin has been lost and the depth is not be known. The full thickness tissue loss in which actual depth of an ulcer is completely obscured by the sludge and the ester. Okay, so this stage is not be assessed by in the presence of sludge and the ester. Sludge is a yellow, green, gray, and brown color secretion, and ester is a black color. It is a kind of tissue that is dead on the wound area. Okay, So if they are present, net sludge and ester are present on the wound area, we cannot able to assess that it is which type of stage. Okay. Until sludge and scar ester are not be removed, the true depth of wound cannot be determined. And it can, if the presence of sludge and ester are on the ulcer, bed ulcer, bed sore, so we can say it may be stage 3 and stage 4. This is a picture. Here you see, this is a ester formation, and here this is a sludge. Okay, there's two type of wound that show you ester and sludge. Okay, sludge is like a yellow, green, gray, brown secretion, and scar is a black color. So if it is present on the wound, we cannot able to assess that which kind of stage of this ulcer. First we have removed this ester and sludge, then we are able to determine the stage of bed sore. Okay, the next is the suspected deep tissue injury, and it's also in this stage the depth is unknown. Okay, and in this it is a purple or brown localized area of discolored intact skin, and it have a blood blister. Okay, blister is filled with blood, and it is caused by applying a huge amount of pressure and shear, and it damages the underlying soft tissue. Okay, and this area may be preceded by tissue with the painful, firm, mussy and buggy, and warm or cooler compared to the adjacent tissue. So here meaning of mussy is like that wound area is spongy. Okay, and buggy is means like the area is very soft and having more amount of fluid filled in this area. Okay, buggy is means like that. So in this area, the starting in this area tissue have pain, firmy means solid, and mussy, buggy, warm and cool as compared to the adjacent side, as compared to the nearby side of the wound area. This is a diagram. Here you see there is no tissue, there is no open wound, only the tissue is damaged by applying a huge amount of pressure, and here huge amount of pressure. Okay, and applying a shear only on this area. So here in this is a real diagram of on our patient. That is a brown maroon and purple color wound. Okay, and it have a blister that is filled with blood, and when you apply a little pressure, the patient feel pain on this area, and that area may be messy and buggy. Okay, understand? Thank you for listening me, and keep watching my video and subscribe.